So again, we have a deck of cards. Give the cards a little riffle shuffle if you like. Okay. For the first time, you'd have a spectator name a number between 1 and 5. It's a completely free choice. They can either think of it or name it. So let's say they say 4 out loud. So 1, 5. Here's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You don't need the rest of these. So again, spectator names the number. Let's say they say 4. They can name any number they want. You turn around. Spectator peeks their card, all right, gathers up the 5 cards. They can shuffle them up. Okay. You take the cards, put them behind your back, and then say, no, nope, nope, yes, and nope. For the first time, you have the spectator announce their card. They say 6 clubs. Of course, you show them that you predicted. Now you're going to do this again. You can mix up the cards. 1, 2, 3, 4. This time you have the spectator merely think of a number. They just think of a number. You turn around so you're not looking. So let's say that this time the spectator thinks of 2. They peek the card. They never mention what number they peaked. They gather up the cards. They shuffle them up. Okay, they tell you they're done. You take the cards, put them behind your back, underneath the table, and then say, nope. 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 Yup. Have the spectator name their card. They say the Queen of Spades. All right. You show them you knew they didn't pick that one. You knew they didn't pick that one. And you knew they didn't pick that one. They say the Queen of Spades. And of course, 6 clubs and the Queen of Spades. Now that's a cool trick. But here from the get-go was a prediction that sat out. Nothing else in there. There is a prediction in there. Okay, nothing else. Regular envelope. You have them open it up. And of course, 6 of clubs and the Queen of Spades.